New research in America may hold the answer. It seems that as Britain's forgotten army were arriving in France, they were also literally being painted out of history.
We see a little figure up here. The flag is newer, the little face is older.
Well, that's a great sign.
All roll that year. Despite this, in Paris, French artists were working to include them in a huge triumphant mural that they were making in the hope of an Allied victory. It was called the Pantheon de la Guerre, and the finished work would be the biggest painting in the world. Longer than a football pitch, it would be exhibited in a specially built circular gallery in Paris.
The Pantheon de la Guerre was kind of a who's who of the World War.
Today, the mural no longer exists in its original form, but this photograph, published in a pamphlet accompanying the exhibition, gives an idea of its scope and ambition. Art historian Mark Levitch believes that the Pantheon holds a secret, which explains why the Chinese laborers have been forgotten by history.
This is the foldout that captures the entire painting, the Pantheon de la Guerre. It is the only rendering we have of the entire composition.
The mural featured over 5,000 figures portraying all 23 Allied nations that participated in the war.
We start with the Italian section, then we move over here to the Belgian section. The section is labeled England.
Each country was represented by the massed ranks of its war heroes in their national costumes and uniforms.
This is the American section, and it was hastily painted in 1917.
The Americans were added as an afterthought to a virtually finished composition when they joined the war. The question is, who was sacrificed to make way for this important new ally? Mark has discovered a previously unpublished letter from one of the world's leading experts in the painting, which reveals how the Pantheon's artists made room.
When the war-weary French artists heard in 1917 that Woodrow Wilson had decided to come into the conflict, French enthusiasm was tremendous. Now, the artists set about in feverish haste to clear the extreme left-end panel that had been dedicated to the nations of the Far East. The question is there material evidence that could show that the Far Eastern allies, including the Chinese and especially the Chinese laborers, were an important part of the original painting? That's really what I'm hoping we can uncover.
The original mural no longer exists as a whole, but the American section was salvaged to form a much smaller work on display today at the National First World War Museum in Kansas. It is this American section that interests Mark.
One area I think we want to focus on is somewhere around here, the American flag. And if you can look, you see it up
there. Yeah, I see
it
up there.
Mark has enlisted the help of expert conservator Peggy DeWitt to try and find proof that the Chinese have been removed.
Would you be able to find evidence of that?
I don't know what we'll find. I need to get up there and examine it.
Excellent.
Much closer and in more detail.
Peggy is looking for a trace of the Chinese laborers beneath the painting's surface.
Stop. Okay. Right here.
First, she uses raking light to identify areas where the original painting has been altered.
I'm looking for brush strokes that are incongruent with the rest of the painting.
Infrared allows Peggy to look for the ghosting of figures beneath the painted surface, like an X-ray. Ultraviolet light shows the different ages of paint.
I can tell you that this guy is original because he fluoresces kind of green. What we're looking for is the heads are usually a light color, so it would be little circles, almost.
Then, Peggy spots a mysterious figure amongst the American dignitaries.
Mark, we see a little figure up here with a cap on, and it doesn't look like a regular uniform, it looks like a cap. This figure right here.
The ultraviolet light will tell Peggy if the mysterious figure is older than the American flag.
The flag is newer. It fluoresces a little bit more purple. The little face behind here is older. It fluoresces a little bit more blue-green.
Well, that's a great sign.
It seems like the figure ran all the way behind the flag.
Has Peggy discovered evidence that Chinese laborers were in the painting before the Americans were painted over them? By marveling at the Pantheon of war heroes depicted on the largest painting ever made. The vast mural no longer exists, but enhanced photographs of the painting taken at the time show how it would have looked when it was first exhibited in 1919. Art historian Mark Levitch believes that a group of Chinese laborers were unceremoniously painted out to make way for the United States when they entered the war. But on closer inspection of the 5,000 figures in the original painting, Mark has spotted a lone Chinese laborer crouching at the feet of the Americans.
So this is the hastily painted American section from 1917 that they painted over the Far Eastern Allies. And you can see over here in the corner, the sole token Chinese laborer who's pictured seated.
The American section of the Pantheon is on display today at the National First World War Museum in Kansas. It had been damaged but was restored and edited in 1959 by Kansas artist Daniel McMorris. Mysteriously, the token Chinese laborer sitting on the steps by the US flag has vanished too, leaving Mark with another puzzle.
I know that he was cut out of the edited painting, but if there's evidence of where that fragment went and sort of how the decision was made to get rid of it, that would be great.
Mark has tracked down the last surviving member of McMorris's original team of assistants, Jack Cox, to try and find out what happened.
Hey, Jack, hello, buddy. Nice to see you.
These are random shots that I did by the small Polaroid camera.
So these are Polaroids that you took?
Polaroids that I took.
At his studio?
At his studio.
As you guys were working on it.
Right.
This one is particularly interesting to me because it seems to show that the Chinese laborer, who we see here in the original,
mm-hmm. has been painted out.
Painted
here.
Out, right there. So this was an area that you worked on?
Yes. I worked on the steps down there, getting okay. that clear for whatever he was going to put there.
Okay. Some of the figures were moved over here.
Yeah.
But this guy, who was on the steps, does not reappear. So we're sort of trying to figure out, you know, why he took him out. Yeah. Did he tell you sort of cut out this piece?
No, I did none of. I had no part of that at
you
all.
Had no
Mine
part of
was
the
all
cutting?
Painting.
I see.
I would just simply ask him, what portion do you want me to work on today? And I'm sure, or maybe I shouldn't say this, that he didn't consider the Chinese laborers all that important to the entire picture. I remember working a lot on those steps.
Yeah.
So I probably was painting him out.
I think the Pantheon de la Guerre, in many respects, is a prism for seeing how an entire group of people who participated in the war have been erased from history. And even have that one token laborer removed. This is the perfect metaphor for understanding the Western perception of Chinese participation in World War I.